Groots en majesteitelijk. Zo moet men circus worden. Met mensen die zich vergapen. Met luid applaus voor mijn paarden, mijn sterren. De hoogstand met al mijn 12 lievelingen zal het hoogtepunt worden. In mijn eigen circus. Die droom zal ik ooit waarmaken. Ook al zal dit offers kosten en zijn tol eisen van mijn geliefde.
If you're born in the circus, it's always in you. You will always love it. You find in your heart that's where you belong, and you always will belong there. You can never get that out of you. I am the great-great-granddaughter of Oscar Carré. My family are in circus. I grew up on circus. And over the years, I did several acts. I did the tightrope, did a cradle, rope act, hung by my hair. I did flying trapeze. So a flying act always. I have an obsession with my family history, particularly the circus and just everything about it. But clearly my roots and the fact that Oscar built this theatre is very important to me because it's sort of kept the family on track in the circus. And it's a long dynasty of circus people.
It looks strong.
He's one of the strongest and fastest.
Fastest, okay, yeah, he looks like he's...
Look, the body, it's all in muscles and tiny feet.
Hey.
He's one of the best.
One of the best.
One of the best.
You have a favorite. This is your favorite.
This is my favorite.
Were you brought up in training with the horses, or is this something you came on to do?
I can say that I born on a horse.
Born on a horse.
Yeah.
Okay, all right. Oh, when I was a kid, about 6, 7 years old, I was bitten by a horse carrying a hay bale.
Yeah.
So I turned around, dropped it, and I hit it. And my grandfather was standing about where the wall was, and with a whip, got me twice on the back. Clack, clack.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And he was right.
Yeah, he was right. That was my fault. Was my fault.
Aangenaam. Carré. Oscar Carré. Ik werd geboren in het circus van mijn vader, Wilhelm Carré. Naar school ben ik nooit geweest. Maar ik spreek vloeiend Frans, Duits, Engels en Russisch.
en Nederlands. Maar Leider met een accent dat ik nooit helemaal ben kwijtgeraakt. En als men mij vraagt hoeveel benen 8 paarden hebben, zie ik meteen 32 dravende benen voor me.
And that was the first montage they made of the photographs of Papa with the horses. They were doing the high school.
Is that not you?
Yeah, it's me with the Roman riding.
And that's you as well. And Grandpa there.
And Papa, that's the carousel with the horses. All the horses in the ring. Those
are
Norwegian.
Wasn't that copied from Oscar?
Yeah, well, he was famous for that, eh? He had 50 horses in the ring at once. And he was actually featured in one of the programs and the posters that used to draw the people to the circus with this.
Yeah, that's...
I mean, obviously, it was full
of... Good family tradition.
I mean, that's about 25, 30 horses in there.
Oscar had, I think it was 13 horses in a half circle, and he used to make them rear up on their hind legs. And they used to stand all of them together on their hind legs. And that was one of his most famous trademarks. It's kind of a very difficult thing to get all the horses to do it together. And it was something very new at the time. Nobody had done it. It's dangerous, apart from anything else, because they come down on top of you when you're trying to do. So it goes against a horse's sort of natural thing. I mean, he clearly had a gift with horses.
Als kind reis ik met mijn vader circus door heel Europa. Belgrado, Wenen, Sint-Petersburg, Hamburg, Berlijn. En elk jaar komen we naar Amsterdam voor de grote kermis op het Amstelveld.
The Carré family visited Holland in 1864 for the first time. And they had a wooden circus, not a tent, but a wooden circus. And from the moment the Carrés visited Amsterdam, The Hague and other places, the public was excited. When Oscar could walk, he was...
In those days,
he was thrown on a horse and, he had to fiddle on the horse.
And which is why he was so good at both. Yeah. Very clearly, two things at once.
Ik herinner me nog goed dat ik op het Amstelveld mijn paardentoeren deed. Ik sta op de rug van 2 galopperende paarden terwijl ik viool speel. Dat doet niemand me na. Zelfs niet bij het grote circus van Ernst Rens. Ik voel me altijd best in Amsterdam. Alleen jammer dat de kermis altijd zoveel laag volk aantrekt. Als ik kijk naar Sint-Petersburg, het grote circus van Ernst Rens, dan is dat wel wat anders. Een tempel die gewijd is aan de hoge kunst van het equestrische spektakel.
You see, Luan, look, this is interesting, the family tree of where we come from. There's Oscar Carré, obviously the one that started it all. Goes down here to Albert Carré and Schumann. And then from there is Albert Carré, which was your uncle.
Yes.
Or my uncle, I should say. Freddie, Harry, which is your granddad.
Harry's grandpa.
And then following down on our line, there's myself, your mom. There's you.
Maybe that Boyke should be underneath because he is 7 years younger than me.
Oh, I don't know how that gets sorted out.
I think it should be age. Or beauty, beauty before age. Let's have a look. These were the Carré sisters.
I wonder how they fit into this.
He definitely was in the circus. They were never in the circus.
But look at the schooling there. It's so sort of classical, that, isn't it, with the schooling.
I think it's so beautiful. I much prefer that schooling now. I wish they did that more nowadays.
Nu mijn vader mij het circus heeft nagelaten, gaan we verder als circus Oscar Carré. Ik moet mijn naam vestigen. Ik moet mijn paarden tot nog grotere hoogte aanmoedigen. Ik doe de hoogstand En Amalia zal als Madame Carré de dressuur leiden. En met haar perfecte rijstijl het publiek nog meer in verrukking brengen dan ik.
Oscar Carré, your forefather,
yes,
was best friends with my forefather, Isaac Schuitvoerder. And he was also his biggest star. Maybe it talks a bit better if I can present you with this petit momentum. This is a picture of Isaac Schuitvoerder, alias Auguste Stupid. They were both horsemen.
That sounds very like a real possibility, because they both enjoyed that they both were doing what they loved, which was the horses.
Yeah, I mean, they slept with their wives, but if they could, they would have slept with their horses, I think.
Most probably.
Je zag niet dat hij heel goed kon rijden, want Auguste Domme, hij heet niet voor niks Auguste Domme, dus hij viel altijd bijna. Maar juist dat bijna vallen, dat is eigenlijk het meest moeilijke wat er is. En vooral op een stijgend paard is dat een grote kunst om bijna net niet te vallen. Dus dat was echt zijn specialisme. Dus zij hebben een soort wederzijds respect waarschijnlijk, wat ze bij elkaar zagen, van absolute paardenkunstenaars. De 19e eeuw was heel erg een tijd van paarden. Dus je had een paardentram. Het leger werd helemaal, bestond uit paarden. Het paard was absoluut status. Oscar Carré was zo'n paardenkunstenaar dat, dat dwong enorm veel respect af bij de elite. Want die deed in principe hetzelfde. Die hadden tijd genoeg en die waren ook alleen maar aan het paardrijden.
Vandaag zeer hoog bezoek ontvangen. De voltallige koninklijke familie was daar om de voorstelling bij te wonen. En de koning zegt er mij toe het predicaat koninklijk te willen verlenen. Stel je voor, Koninklijk Nederlands Circus Oscar Carré. Königlich, dat heeft zelfs Rens niet.
These are the very personal, some of the personal belongings of Oscar Carré. And these are very rare, unique objects. You see here a piece of china, and here you see the blazoen of the Dutch royal house. Koninklijk Nederlands Circus O. Carré, Oscar Carré. And this is what he really was after. On a personal level, King William III granted him the privilege to present himself as royal, as koninklijk.
He loved that royal connection, didn't he?
Hij heeft een aantal keren zelfs opgetreden op Huize het Loo. Voor een privévoorstelling voor Willem III en de hofhouding. En er schijnt zelfs, maar dat is ook weer zo'n circusmythe, dat hij bij de verjaardag van de kleine Wilhelmina, dat ze een mini-circusje in haar slaapkamer gegeven hebben. De latere koningin Wilhelmina, die was ook verzot op het circus, is hier vaak in het gebouw geweest. Ja, dus die kreeg dat als verjaardagscadeau. Oscar Carré, in haar slaapkamer.
Here I have a napkin ring. And you see here MC, Maximilian Carré. And here in the back you see the countenance of the young Queen Wilhelmina of the Netherlands. So again, this link with royal circles is obvious. Huh? You can't miss that.
Left. Yes.
Je had zeg maar in Wenen in die tijd de welbekende keizerin Sissi, keizerin Elisabeth van Oostenrijk-Hongarije, gespeeld door Romy Schneider in alle zoete kleurenfilms die iedereen wel kent. Sissi was ook helemaal, zoals alle elite in die tijd, geobsedeerd door het circus en dan met name het kunstrijden te paard. Sissi had vreemd genoeg in Wenen een mini-circusje. Haar vader had ook een mini-circusje. Dus dat geeft al aan dat die elite een beetje doorgedraaid was in het circusgebeuren. En daar probeerde ze op haar manier dan te kunstrijden. Maar het verhaal gaat dat Oscar Carré haar daadwerkelijk getraind heeft om zeg maar, de fijnere trucs onder de knie te krijgen.
Ah, Wien. Mijn keizerin, Elisabeth, Sissi. Een bekoorlijker Amazone heb ik nog nooit ontmoet. Voltaire, Pas de Deux, Piaf, Capriole, Levade. Zij kan het allemaal, als geen ander. Vanavond ben ik genodigd op Schönbrunn. Een diner met zijn hoogheid Frans Jozef. En natuurlijk Sissi. Ik zal haar vanmiddag nog extra onderricht geven. Om haar knieval met Mahmoud te perfectioneren. Zodat ze die vanavond kan uitvoeren om haar keizer en het voorname gezelschap te plezieren.
En wasn't there a story that him and Sissi had a bit of a fling?
There are a lot of stories about Oscar and Sissi, but Sissi was much more older than Carré, but who cares? But I don't know if there's any truth about it, because Keizer Franz Josef, her husband, was a real admirer of Oscar himself. He visited the circus too. He gave Oscar Carré a really nice pipe with one of the circus acts of Oscar Carré built in it. It's a really nice object.
Oscar presenting his Trakehna stallions. He used this immediately as a brand. So it was his. So everybody knew that he was linked with the Emperor of Austria.
Franz Josef gave him this pipe, and Queen Sissi gave him the nicest horse of the stable, a Mammut. And he rode for years on this horse.
Yeah, a love relationship with Sissi. And there's some proof that this is true.
You think it's true?
She gave him her favorite horse, Mammut. So, and her husband gave him this special pipe. So I don't know.
Would the husband give him a pipe though, if it was true?
Yeah, it's a sort of a Freudian thing to give a pipe to another guy. I don't know.
Okay.
And why do you think it was so important for Oscar to have that sort of royal connection?
Well, I think there are two main reasons. One is a personal reason, that he did not want from very young age on, he did not want to be associated with fairs and with sideshows.
Yes,
he wanted to move ahead. He wanted to have a better part of it. So that's a personal inspiration.
Right.
And the other thing, I think, is an argument of marketing. So leading a company, it would be better to be associated with,
of course,
with royal
So he was doing his
circles.
PR. Yeah.
I think he was a very, very keen and very talented in PR.
Oh. Whoa!
There. And from there, I would swing round over the horse's neck, onto the floor, and then go vault back onto the horse again. So it was a whole little series of tricks within that one trick. Oh, yes, there's your old man. There you go. Yeah. What happened there? I'd done that for about, I don't know, a year, 2 years, and all of a sudden something happened and it clicked. I think it happened by accident, and I fell off the horse, off the four horses, and they stopped dead. And then we had to take the horses out and start the whole thing all over again. And it actually created quite a sensation because people actually thought it was a true accident. So I incorporated it into the act and it actually stayed as part of the act always.
This is where it is. Well, the Christmas tree's in the way, but these are all the horses, every horse that Oscar trained, and these are all the original hairs that come from the horse. So each one was done by its... And every horse that was trained in South Africa, okay, was named after one of these horses that are on here.
Mammut. This one looks like Lepitano.
Yes.
Yeah. Mammut.
Mammut.
Don Juan.
Don Juan.
1 mei 1873. De openingsavond van mijn Wiener Holzbau. Het is gelukt. Mijn eigen theater hier in Wenen. Midden in het statige Prater aan de Feuerwerksallee. De kranten schrijven over de vorstelijke allure van het Königliche Niederländische Circus Oscar Carré. Eindelijk ontsnapt aan de kermis.
And that was one of your girlfriends?
Sorry, that's nasty.
Oh, no, you were the best-looking person in there, but I mean...
This one here.
I like this one.
That one with... That's because you can't see my face. That's very nice, thank you.
I just always wanted to see you with pie in your face,
The pie in my face. And that was soap all mixed up. What else have we got here?
That's a nice one. You like Kissing your horse. That's very romantic.
Doesn't look like the horse is appreciating it very much.
No, I don't think so. Clearly, you weren't his type.
No.
Thank God.
Do you remember this one during your school holidays?
I do.
You were a ring mistress.
Yes, I do indeed. Tell me about the boots.
Quite sexy, aren't they?
Well, I don't know about that.
And what about the pants? The hot pants.
And do you remember when I tried to get Reggie to cut them up
high
and she wouldn't?
And she wouldn't cut them for you.
She said, no, that's disgusting. Oh, who's that ugly person?
That's you, ugly person. Don't say that about my daughter.
Hanging by my hair.
1982.
Yeah.
There you were the star attraction. I didn't even know you were doing this. I got the fright of my life when I saw you at the end of this crane. Well, how high were you? About 30 metres in the air.
That was higher than
this. Well, that was high enough. But when you were on the crane and doing that in the arena... Yeah. And then somebody shouted out, stop! And, then you had a big bump on your head, and that was just the day I came down to see you. And you had tears in your eyes, and I said, Luanne, why are you doing this? You don't have to do this.
You know why I did it? Because you dared me. You said to me, you'll never do it.
I can't believe I ever threatened you like that.
No, you said you'd never do it, so I just had to prove you wrong. The thrill is being in the ring, if you're doing a flying act like I was doing, the joy of just standing on the pedestal, knowing that everybody just wants to see what's going to happen. They want to see what trick you're going to do. They want to see you catch it. In the back of their mind, they might be wishing just a little bit that they see you miss it or something happens. But that's part of why you're there. You're there to provide the excitement, the joy, the fun.
Nou, een circus hart hebben is zo'n lef hebben en zo voor je act gaan. Ja, op een niveau wat wij ons niet kunnen voorstellen als publiek. Maar dat je echt hart voor de zaak hebben. En dat, ja, dat is misschien wel het ware circus hart.
And when you get it right, it's the most amazing feeling. Because it's an adrenaline rush, you just feel, yes, I've done it. And then when you hear the applause, the fact that the audience appreciate you, it just makes you feel even better. And the more applause you get, the better you feel. It's just the most amazing feeling. To try and explain it to somebody who's never had it, it would be just so difficult because it's not something you can explain in words. You have to feel it. You have to feel that sensation of actually enjoying every second of what you're doing.
Every winter, the circus came to Amsterdam, and the papers are full of articles about Oscar and what his adventures were in the last year. And, and when the circus is coming to Amsterdam, everybody is standing at the Amstel and yelling and shouting. And well, it's an event, and it feels it must have been like coming home.
He was clearly very well loved, huh, in the country, isn't
he? Yeah, he was loved a lot, and everybody knew the names of his children.
Net voor het circus Oscar Carré op zijn hoogtepunt was, was zijn grootste concurrent was het circus van Ernst Jacob Rens. Dat was 2 of 3 keer zo groot. Dus Oscar Carré probeerde altijd hem net, ja, een loer te draaien of voor te zijn. En Carré heeft op een gegeven moment Rens zover gekregen om een weddenschap aan te gaan. En de weddenschap was wie krijgt de meeste raspaarden zover om te kunnen stijgeren en een rondje te draaien.
Rens beweerde dat alleen hij 12 hengsten tegelijk op hun achterbenen kon laten stijgeren. Nu, hij kwam nauwelijks tot 8. Mij kost het geen moeite om mijn 12 getrouwen hun kunsten te laten vertonen. Het kost hem niet alleen de 10.000 Deutschmark die we hadden ingezet, maar het bewijst dat hij niet onoverwinnelijk is. Wat me wel een doorn in het oog is, is dat Rens nu al stenen circustheaters heeft. In Berlijn, Breslau, Sint-Petersburg en Wenen. En ik moet me behelpen met die houten bouwsels in Wenen en Amsterdam. Als ik kijk naar dat prachtvolle Paleis voor Volksvlijt op het Frederiksplein, moet het toch mogelijk zijn om in mijn geliefde Amsterdam ook een stenen circustheater neer te zetten.
He planned to build a stone circus in Amsterdam far more earlier. But then the authorities thought we don't want this circus on that place or on that spot. So Oscar grew really angry about the authorities. And in Germany, he was much more welcome by the authorities. There was a lot of administration, a lot of quarrels and conflicts before the Amsterdam authorities said yes to this project.
Eindelijk. Het Stenen Theater aan de Amstel komt er nu echt. Een koninklijk carré-theater is een fraai paleis der kunsten geworden. Een tempel aan de hippologie gewijd. Met diep rood fluweel in de rangen en loges. Majesteitelijke foyers en een kleurrijk gedecoreerde zaal. De wijdste en hoogste die ik ooit heb gebouwd. Nu, in mijn eigen theater, voel ik nog meer trots als ik zie hoe Amalia en nu ook Keetjen met hun bevallige kunsten het publiek weten te betoveren. Het is groots, zoals Amalia mij de afgelopen jaren heeft bijgestaan. Zonder haar was deze droom nooit uitgekomen.
My first conscious memory is being on the train when I was very tiny. My brother and I at one point slept on the top bunk, and because you could fall out easily, it was only a single bunk, and we slept top and tail. And then my parents put some hooks on the ceiling and they put a fishing net and underneath so that when the train shunted, we couldn't fall out. And it was absolutely fantastic. It's, you've got your family and friends next door to you. When you're traveling, you're up and down the corridor as a child, you know, it's fantastic. You can hear the lions roaring at night. When you're traveling, there's so much, you know, good. It's just a magic environment.
There's a picture of your mom and you.
That's on the train,
yes. And there's you.
Yeah.
And there's your little brother.
And there's all the dirty nappies.
And there's the dirty nappies there, yes. Oh, lordy. And to imagine great. We lived like that for 13 years on the train, never got off. But they were wonderful years. Mommy still says they were the happiest years of her life.
I think so too. There's nothing like it. There's nothing like it. The train was good. Used to pull down the tent at night, load everything up on the train, the animals, everything, and then used to drive through the night to the new place. It's a very nice life from that. It's not an easy life, believe me, because when you're doing maybe sometimes 2-3 shows a day on a one-day stand, you have to be there early in the morning. If you're doing any sort of aerial act or something, you have to be there when the tent goes up because you need to rig all your equipment. And then you're doing 2 or 3 shows, then after the show, when everything's coming down, you have to take all the rigging down, back to the train, made your dinner, played some cards. It's just a wonderful life.
The circus was always moving by train. They had their own train, Oscar Carré's extra train. It was a huge train, about 30 wagons. And when they ended the circus in Amsterdam, they went to Den Bosch. And then from Den Bosch, they carried along to Hanover. And just before Hanover, another train crashed on the Carré train. And it was dramatic.
Amalia was de vrouw van Oscar Cray, was op slag dood. En twee van de kleine kinderen van Oscar Cray zijn ternauwernood aan de dood ontsnapt. En was eigenlijk een groot geluk dat die niet overleden zijn tijdens het ongeluk.
Deze meimaand van 1891 is de gruwelijkste uit mijn bestaan. Alles wat mij lief is, is mij ontnomen. Mijn allerliefste Amalia is niet meer. Godzijdank is de kleine Keetje ongedeerd. Maar die arme Martha en Elise, ze zullen nooit meer kunnen rijden. En mijn lieve, trouwe Isaac, zal hij ooit nog kunnen terugkeren als de grote August en capriolen op zijn paard uithalen die zelfs ik hem niet kan nadoen?
Tijdens dat ongeluk is mijn aartsvader Isaac Schuitenvoerder zwaar gewond geraakt en ook zodanig getraumatiseerd dat dat het einde was van zijn carrière als Auguste Domme.
Wat een zwarte dag. Wat een leed. Toch moeten we verder. Ik kan niet anders.
What astonished me most was, well, you read about circus life, mm-hmm. how harsh it is, how severe, and that it's you fall and you stand up and mm-hmm. you play again. And after this accident, I think within 4 days, mm-hmm. they have their opening of the circus in Hanover. Oscar is there in the ring with bandages on his head, carrying his youngest son, Ernest, who is only 2 years old. And the artists are doing their acts.
When my grandmother died, my father worked that day.
Really?
That's
the same.
That's how it is. The show must go on.
The
day very
before
good.
Death, he just was in the ring.
En het hele treinongeluk aan zich was zo traumatisch voor dat circus dat het circus daarna ging wel door, maar op een compleet andere manier. Dus je kan zeggen dat het een soort nieuw hoofdstuk was het, maar ook misschien wel echt het begin van het einde voor Circus Carré. In Amerika had je Buffalo Bill en toen was het opeens heel erg in, ook in Europa, om cowboytje, indiaantje te zien. Oscar Carré heeft dat ook op zijn manier dan naar Europa gehaald. En dan zag je op het toneel en op de piste een kolonistendorp wat in de fik werd gestoken door bloeddorstige indianen die vervolgens weer in de pan werden gehakt door het Amerikaanse leger.
It is apparent that Oscar Carré mounted episodes with subjects known to a general public. So everybody knew about the gold rush. And he took that as a starting point for bringing in Indians, cowboys, horses of course, all the maneuvers.
Yes, all the stunt riding and the,
And here again, another example, the Crimea War had ended, and here you see, of course, that the Turks are the bad people, and they are here doing bad things to a wonderful lady. And
it's almost like he was doing a news flash for everybody as well.
Yeah. So
what was happening?
Yeah, and of course it was a bit exaggerated, but people knew of all these things happening in Turkey when it and after that it was defeated, and they got an episode referring to that common knowledge.
Yes.
Yeah.
And also, again, with all the horses.
Yeah.
He got something that he could use.
Yeah, and horses, yes. Carré was in the front row when applying new techniques. He made an ice rink. At least it looked like an ice rink with blue gloomy limelights on it.
Yes.
So people thought, wow, how did he do it?
Vandaag hoorde ik tijdens de matinee een jongen tegen zijn zusje zeggen: wat een schaatsenrijders. Zo heb ik het nog nooit in mijn leven gezien. Pa zegt dat het Amerikanen zijn. De deksel. Ik wou dat ik ook Amerikaan was. En aan het eind kwam er een sneeuwbui. En alle sneeuwvlokken waren gekleurd van het licht. Dat ook van alle kleuren was. Het was zo mooi dat als je je ogen dicht deed, je het nog zag. En toen het spel uitging, hebben we allemaal in onze handen geklapt. Dat ze er zeer van deden.
It's almost as if circus has come a full circle, because they've had nowadays, if you look at circus, it's very much like a variety show where you get an acrobat, then you'll have a clown act, but everything is acts. It's all segmented and it's all put together by a ringmaster. Whereas there you had a whole scene with it. And nowadays, if you look at Cirque du Soleil, something like that, it's the same thing. Everything's linked together. It's the scenes of something in the show. You'd most probably find this was all, although they were scenes, it would be the basic theme of the whole circus. So it's very similar to what's going on now. It's the modern, age.
Yeah, yeah.
It was the modern age then as well,
yeah,
clearly.
Yeah, so Cirque du Soleil invented something that existed already.
Exactly, yeah. So he wasn't that original.
No,
he
no,
thinks
no, no.
he was, but
well,
Oscar did it before. Oscar did it before.
Ieder jaar had Oscar Carré weer een nieuw spektakelstuk. Om origineel te blijven was best moeilijk voor hem. Dus hij probeerde steeds het nieuwste van het nieuwste voor elkaar te krijgen met technische snufjes. Zo had hij op een gegeven moment, wat nieuw in die tijd was, in de piste een compleet meer in een rubberen waterbassin laten nabouwen met stoomboten, met kleine roeibootjes waar orkesten in zaten. En eenden zelfs zaten erin. Ongehoord spektakelstuk.
He chose for the big spectacle as a proto. Well, later on you had these great and mounted film.
Yes.
Film episodes by Cecil B. DeMille.
Yeah.
And so he's a kind of proto film entrepreneur.
Deze nieuwe ontdekking, die men film heeft gedoopt, biedt ongekende mogelijkheden. Men kan voorstellingen vastleggen en ze laten herbeleven door een publiek dat zich op een geheel andere plaats bevindt.
Niemand kende film, dus het was sowieso een stunt om daar met een of ander magisch apparaat. Oscar Carré had weer iets nieuws bedacht om dat dan zogenaamd te filmen. Niemand wist natuurlijk wat filmen was, maar het was natuurlijk nog magischer om een week later die 10 seconden die al voorbij waren in tijd, om die weer terug te zien, ja, in het Circus Carré. Toen Oscar Carré zelf zo'n apparaat heeft aangeschaft, heeft hij de intocht van de koninnen gefilmd. Dus dat is ook binnen Nederland een van de oudste stukjes filmmateriaal wat voorhanden is. En dat heeft Oscar Carré laten filmen. Dus hij was ook echt absoluut de filmpionier van Nederland.
Prinses Wilhelmina naast haar moeder koningin Regentes Emma.
Daar komt de stoet aan. Reeds openen zich de monden tot gejuich. De armen heffen zich. De hoeden worden gegrepen en gezwaaid. De militairen hebben moeite het deinend mensenzwart in toom te houden. Men krijgt lust. Nee, men moet zich inhouden om niet zelf te gaan roepen: hiep, hiep, hoera! En toch is de gehele geschiedenis maar een vertoning, met hel licht geworpen op doek.
naar dat verschrikkelijke treinongeluk heeft in ieder geval Oscar Carré geprobeerd het op een goede manier vol te houden. Dus die is hertrouwd, heeft ook geprobeerd dat circus steeds te vernieuwen. Maar toen de 20e eeuw eenmaal begon, werd dat steeds moeilijker. Mensen waren verwender, wouden steeds meer spektakel. En ja, spektakel kost geld, dus dat de zakelijke kant van het circus ging steeds minder. Moest iedere keer weer opgebracht worden om die artiesten te betalen, om die paarden te onderhouden, om alle vaste circusgebouwen in Europa te onderhouden. Dus dat werd steeds minder.
Het paardenspel is niet meer wat het geweest is. Het publiek wil nu het spektakel van de film. Circus Rens is reeds failliet. De tijden zijn slecht. En nu ook Ada is overleden, heb ik de kinderen vandaag naar zwager Solomonski in Moskou laten vertrekken. Het lijkt nu dat de dagen van het circus geteld zijn.
It's like a form of suicide because his heart must have been broke. I mean, I've never heard the story before, so it's kind of a... it's quite hard to get my head around that at the moment, but... no, definitely, I can't believe that he would do it. I mean, he was such a horse person. I mean, horses drove his whole life, virtually. I can't believe that he would just shoot them, you know. It wasn't a moment of cruelty, although a lot of people might watching nowadays might think that. I certainly don't think that. I think it was an act of love.
It's a strange story because there's only one source that tells this story. It's a newspaper article, an interview with Oscar Carré. And in this one-off interview with Oscar Carré, he tells this very sad story.
Is it true about the horses that he shot?
I don't think it's true. That's another myth. It's a very famous myth. The thing is that within a few years, Oscar is joining a show in Groningen for his colleague Albert Schumann, in favor of his colleague Albert Schumann, with 8 Trakehner horses. And they have the same names. So I thought, well, it's maybe it's just an evidence of his great sense for drama, and maybe he just made it even more dramatic than it already was.
And what do you think that says about Oscar, about his mentality, that he would sort of make that legend?
He's really good in dealing with the press.
Manipulative.
And he's making really nice stories, and he wanted to do everything to make his circus even more magic than it already was.
Maar de magie is waar het om gaat. Waarom begrijpen de mensen dat niet? Wat is het leven zonder magie? Dat is toch wat het publiek wil. Altijd weer. Tot aan het eind toe. En zelfs dat moet groots en meeslepend zijn.
I wonder who bought flowers. Lucky man, he's got all his wives. So you've got Amalia Simonski, Ada Smith, Edith Adams, another Oscar. Willem, Maximilian. This must be underneath. It's just very emotional thing seeing somebody I've heard so much about my whole life, and it's kind of trying to find out his history and everything, and then coming here, it's almost like meeting him. It's the closest I'm ever going to get to meeting him, I guess. So it's, it's like meeting him, I guess. I'm not going to get closer than this, am I, in all fairness.
Well, I always knew from my father that I had this heritage of Oscar Carré, the greatest circus on the continent in its day, and the building of the Theatre Carré in Amsterdam. But consequently, it built up a standing in my feeling and my life that, yes, I belonged to a very strong heritage in circus, and it really meant something. And very proud of it. I feel very privileged to be part of this heritage. The name, the wonderful name of Carré. Emotionally, I think. A lot of emotion. But having said that, that's life, isn't it?
Circus has its own, it's so unique and so different that I think it inspires people to be passionate about it, to love it, to be obsessed by it, because there's just so many elements to it. You know, there's danger, there's animals, there's thrills, there's people, the costumes, the sawdust, so many elements that come together in one thing.
Cultuur, speciaal voor iedereen.